Cyprus freeway collapse. I will never forget myself coming home that night to my apartment where every single window was shattered and there was a crack in my wall so large I could see Lake Merritt through it. And as the horror dawned that so many people had lost their lives, that so much damage was done to this Bay Area, it was a sobering experience. And yet, we saw how Oakland came together. Today, I am so thrilled to be here as the backdrop to this announcement that will help all Californians be safer. Seconds save lives. Early warning can allow people incredible opportunity to prepare, to cover their heads with the pillows, to duck and roll, to avoid more catastrophic loss like was experienced 30 years ago. And it is a supreme pleasure to introduce leadership in California that is investing in this type of preventive technology before the next big one happens. All of California is safer today because of this incredible groundbreaking announcement. And so with that, it is my pleasure to introduce to you a governor who has demonstrated a bold vision and a willingness to invest in prevention so that we do not have as much tragedy and destruction to deal with after the next big one that we know is inevitable. Governor Gavin Newsom.
Thank you, Mayor. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Mayor, for I've never been on this remarkably new because this is fabulous. And by the way, for all those folks that only watch, I say this lovingly and respectfully, I'm one of them, but not only watch Fox News. That's not the picture you get of San Francisco every night on your television screen. I just want to remind people what a spectacular place this is, the San Francisco Bay Area, the Oakland Bay Area, the San Jose Bay Area, how vibrant it is and how remarkably well this region is doing. And it is appropriate that we are here in this region on this day, an anniversary, 30 years from the Loma Prieta earthquake. Like Mayor Schaaf, I, among many, many that are assembled here today, was in my apartment about to walk out a little late to watch the World Series at a friend's house at 15 Rico Way in the Marina District when all of a sudden I felt the shaking and the old chandelier going back and forth. I naively, at the time, I think they told you to go under the door. Now they say drop, cover, hold. But at the time it was go under the door. And I remember going back and forth and hearing car alarms in the day go off and walked outside and didn't know what the heck would happen. I thought the sewage systems had all burst. It was that thing we learned afterwards called liquefaction that was coming up, something people had predicted but they had never seen in the scale and scope, just a block and a half away where those was that iconic building, lives were lost, that had collapsed, that corner building in the Marina District, and everybody was assembled to help out. It was a moment of pride and spirit, not just tragedy, to see neighbors, folks from all walks of life coming together to help one another. And I say that in that spirit of resilience, the spirit that defines the best of this region, finds the best of a city, San Francisco, that was ravaged by not just the 89 earthquake, but the 1906 earthquake. I remind folks, the flag, the icon on the flag of San Francisco is the Phoenix, rising from the ashes of the earthquake. And so we are cognizant of not only this moment as we reflect on history and our past, but we look to the future. A few years back, a lot of you ran with headlines saying that experts had put out a prediction, 99.7% chance within the next 30 years, 99.7% chance within the next 30 years, we would experience an earthquake greater than 6.7. It was a rather jaw-dropping prediction, particularly from experts that are cautious in making those types of predictions. That's the reality we live in. There's a reason we experience and enjoy such beauty. And that's Mother Nature, with all her glory, but at times her fury. So the price of admission to live here is preparation. That price is paid often by neglect, lack of preparation, lack of intentionality as it relates to making sure that we are prepared to support one another, our families, ourselves in a time of crisis. Today, we are making a big leap forward in terms of focusing attention on prevention. We are announcing the nation's first comprehensive early alert system for earthquakes. We're announcing the ability for millions and millions of Californians to download an app, MyShake. Download the app, MyShake. If millions of people do that, we will have points of contact, the ability to crowdsource information, the likes of which no country in the world has advanced. I say that knowingly that Japan and Mexico have systems already in place in this space. But because of the extraordinary complementary work that was done by UC Berkeley, by Caltech, by USGS, and by our own Office of Emergency Service, we feel we are on the leading and cutting edge in terms of the ability to utilize this technology. But it is only as good as you. If you download that app, we now have another point of contact, and we are now all part of this remarkable capacity to iterate, to experiment, to advance science in real time to make us all more safe. And so I just cannot impress upon folks more the importance of going to the App Store, whatever their device may be, downloading MyShake, and reading the instructions and encouraging friends and family to do the same. This is about 10 seconds. It's about 15 seconds. This could be as much as 20 seconds of early warning. In 20 seconds, that's not an insignificant amount of time to make sure we shut down or slow down the BART, make sure we slow down or shut down an elevator, make sure we open an elevator door or open emergency doors or fire station garage doors to make sure that we turn off equipment. We were talking to Senator Hill a moment ago. He says if you're going to an optometrist and they've got a laser in your eye, to turn the laser off before the procedure, to make sure that we take care of those that are most in need, to take care of the most acute facilities, be it an old refinery, a natural gas facility, to make sure we shut off, I peril of saying this, a transmission line in anticipation. I know you'll probably run with that, so I know that I walked into it, but it is one of the benefits of this system, that the utilities are connected to this system in an earthquake that could prevent a lot of lives and a lot of property damage from occurring. I want to close by thanking Senator Hill for his leadership in this effort. We would not have been here without him, his stubbornness to make sure that not just this governor, but previous governors were supportive of this effort. Some $46 million has been put into this program to date. It operationalizes at about $17 million a year. I was privileged to have the support of the senator and others, and Assemblyman Holden, among other champions of this program, of $16.3 million in this year's budget to get this over the top so we can finally make this announcement. But this is a good investment, a wise and appropriate investment, but it's been a six-year process of formalizing partnerships and procedures and protocols, building out the sensor network, which still has work to be done, and to get us to this point where we're confident that this app will do justice to what we're promoting. Perfect, however, is not on the agenda. So for those of you that rightfully are concerned that we roll this out and there is a seismic activity that's, just around 4.5, which is the trigger for the notification, and it's a little late or it didn't come to your cell phone, we recognize this is a work in progress that we'll have to iterate over the next few years. This is not a perfect system. We are now leaning into this technology, so I don't want to overpromise, but I do want people to know we are prepared to roll this out, and we think we have done justice to the infrastructure that we can confidently make this announcement. I wanted to make it months ago. Mark Ghirardotti behind me said, absolutely not, unless you want me to resign now, because my reputation is more important than that announcement. And I appreciated his candor, but he has assured me that this is the moment, and he's prepared to back up his reputation with this technology and those that have brought it to the fore. Final point of recognition, I want to thank Senator Padilla as well. I know he's your Secretary of State, and you say, what the heck does a Secretary of State have to do with this? Senator Padilla, when he was in the Senate, was a big champion as well of this effort, and he brought it to my attention as Lieutenant Governor and as a former mayor. I tracked his work with Senator Hill and others, and I just, again, want to compliment all of them for their stewardship and their leadership. Forgive me for being so long-winded, but this is a milestone support moment for this region, for the state of California. This is an application for everyone in the state, my shake, but also for this nation and for the world, who I think are looking for this technology to leave clues and this successful implementation to be replicated in parts of the globe, large and small. So with that, let me introduce you our Director of the Office of Emergency Services, who has committed himself to this cause and is very proud, I'm sure, of this moment because of the enormity of work that he and his staff has been doing for the course of many, many years to get us to this announcement today. Mark.
Great. Thank you, Governor, and good morning. Thank you all for being here today. I'm Mark Ghirardotti, the Governor Newsom's Director of the Office of Emergency Services. So 30 years ago today, following the magnitude 6.9 Loma Prieta earthquake that ravaged the Bay Area and Santa Cruz, I personally spent several days down the road from here involved in search and rescue operations at the collapse of the I-880 Cypress structure. Much has happened in the last 30 years in the area of seismic safety and response. We have implemented major seismic retrofit programs, like the replacement of the Bay Bridge behind me, which was a phenomenal endeavor. We have enhanced building codes to increase earthquake resiliency. We have increased public education programs, like today's great shakeout drill involving millions of Californians. And we have built the nation's premier urban search and rescue response system. All significant preparedness and life-saving efforts. And today, I'm proud to be with you all as California again takes arguably one of the most significant next steps towards making our citizens and our communities safer and more prepared for earthquakes. With great leadership and support from Governor Newsom, former Governor Brown, Senator Jerry Hill, former Senator Alex Padilla, Assemblyman Adam Gray, Assemblyman Holden, and after years of research and development that included the placement of thousands of early detection ground motion sensors throughout the state and innovative advancements in technology, Cal OES, in collaboration with the California Integrated Seismic Network partners from the University of California at Berkeley, United States Geologic Survey, Caltech, and the California Geologic Survey, are more than excited to launch the nation's first state earthquake early warning system. Essentially, this system is designed to detect an earthquake that's already started. When the earthquake begins, ground motion sensors detect and gather information rapidly and allow the system to estimate the potential size and location of the earthquake. The system will then send out an alert if the earthquake is potentially harmful, letting you know that shaking is about to arrive in your general location. The alert you will get is called a shake alert. And the amount of warning you will receive will depend on your distance from the epicenter of the earthquake. The further away you are from the epicenter, the more warning time you can receive. The closer to the epicenter of the earthquake you are, the less warning time you will receive. Alerts can be sent in two ways. One way will be through the Wireless Emergency Alert System, or WEA. This system, already enabled on most cell phones for weather emergencies, wildfire events, and amber alerts. Warnings will also come through a new mobile application, as the governor mentioned, for iPhones, iPads, and Android phones called My Shake. Along with information about previous earthquakes and tips for preparedness, which has been developed by our partners at UC Berkeley Seismological Lab. We want every Californian to download the My Shake application, and you'll hear more about that application shortly. As emergency responders, we understand that these early notifications can greatly increase the ability to prevent injuries, mitigate losses, and even save lives. And when you receive an alert, we want you to drop, cover, and hold on, or get to a safe place. And when alerts are issued, we want businesses to protect their employees and mitigate potential losses, or schools to establish automated alarms to warn kids, or transit systems to automatically slow or stop trains, or responders to be able to adequately protect lives and property. Today's announcement also reflects our commitment at Cal OES to using the best available science and technology for earthquake detection and warning, and to develop resilience that will last. While the launch of this new system is an important milestone, and this capability is ready to deploy now, as the governor said, it is not yet perfect. And we will continue to improve the system through new technology, innovative actions, and better telecommunications pathways. And while this major policy action is being implemented before the next big earthquake, instead of after, our research and development efforts will continue as we move forward. California has long been a national leader in emergency management, and now, under Governor Newsom's leadership and his focus on emergency preparedness, we are continuing to lean forward and adopt new techniques and technology to expand the tools we have available to keep Californians safe. To learn more about this new earthquake early warning system and related capabilities, Cal OES has established a website to learn more and to download the earthquake early warning application, My Shake. Please go to www.earthquake.ca.gov. www.earthquake.ca.gov. Now, it's my pleasure to introduce Dr. Richard Allen from the UC Berkeley Seismologic Lab, who has been one of our longest CISN partners, to talk about how the system operates and more about the My Shake app. Dr. Allen.
Thank you, Director Ghilarducci. Thank you, Governor. Thank you, Mayor Schaaf, for being here. And thank you to Jerry Hill as well for his long support of this project. This is a really exciting day. We have been working towards earthquake early warning for many years, and finally, earthquake early warning is here for the whole state of California. So my name's Richard Allen. I am the director of the UC Berkeley Seismology Lab. I'm a seismologist. I live earthquakes. And we have been working on this problem for over a decade at this point, so it's great to see this finally coming to fruition. To reiterate what you've already heard a couple of times, the most important thing that people need to take away today is they need to download the My Shake app. If you download the My Shake app, you'll get early warnings when the next earthquake comes. Now, the idea of earthquake early warning has been around for a long time. It was actually proposed after the 1906 earthquake, 117 years ago. The USGS put out an early version of early warning after the Loma Prieta earthquake, 30 years ago, of course, today. And so we're very pleased that we're now able to actually roll this out for everybody. And as the director mentioned, we're doing this before the next big earthquake. In the past, other countries have rolled out these systems after a big earthquake. At UC Berkeley, we're very proud of the contributions that we've made over the years. We started working on this problem back in 2005 when we started developing and testing the algorithms to generate the alerts, the algorithms that are generating the alerts today. We've then worked to build the collaboration that you see represented here today over the years to build the system. And then we're very proud today to be going that last mile and be providing the My Shake app, which can actually deliver this warning to everybody across California. Now, earthquake early warning, it's important to realize earthquake early warning is about recognizing an earthquake that has begun and the shaking that is coming. So when an earthquake starts, we rapidly detect it and we push out a warning ahead of the shaking, meaning that you may have a few seconds, perhaps 10, 20 seconds worth of warning time. So you may receive the alert before, during, or after the shaking. However, whether you get an alert or whether you feel shaking, the reaction is the same. You drop, cover, and hold on. As the governor mentioned, we still consider this to be a prototype system. We have been building the system over the last few years, but we feel like it's at a point where we can really make a difference. We can reduce the number of injuries, we can reduce the number of fatalities in future earthquakes, and so it's time to put it out. But it will improve over time, and the system may not accurately estimate your experience in an earthquake. So we ask everybody to understand that it's under development and it will get better, but we also think it can do people a lot of good. Finally, I just want to thank all of the folks who have built this system over the course of the years. First of all, of course, our sister academic institutions, Caltech, the University of Oregon, and the University of Washington are part of this partnership. Of course, this is all held together by the US Geologic Survey that is operating the Shake Alert earthquake early warning system that delivers the alerts that MyShake then provides to people across California. Also, we've had the support of the Gordon Betty Moore Foundation, key investment at a key stage to push the technology over the brim and get us to the place where we are today. And of course, we've had the support of legislators, both state legislators, who you can see here today, and also the federal legislators. I want to mention in particular Barbara Feinstein and also Adam Schiff, who really led that effort and when it comes to the House and the Senate side of what's been going on. So thank you everybody for being here. Again, the most important thing is that everybody needs to know that they need to download the MyShake app so that they can get the warning when the next earthquake occurs. So now I'd like to pass it over to Mark Scoggie from the USGS to talk about their piece in this project.
Well, good morning. So today, the anniversary of the destructive Loma Prieta earthquake is a fitting time for pressing the go button on the first statewide public testing of the California Earthquake Early Warning Program. This program is powered by USGS-issued early warnings alerts called Shake Alerts. Now, all of us at USGS remember the 63 lives lost and the thousands of injuries in the San Francisco Bay Area 30 years ago. The magnitude 6.9 Loma Prieta quake was a wake-up call that ended decades of earthquake tranquility in the Bay Area. It was a significant reminder of how important it was and is to prepare for the devastating quakes in the future. Now, it's this inherent danger of earthquakes, such as Loma Prieta, that motivates our USGS scientists and our partners each and every day to keep doing the research that leads to tools to help protect life and property. Interestingly, as Richard mentioned, the Loma Prieta quake also marked the first deployment of a very early forerunner of the Shake Alert system. That time it was used to safeguard the lives of rescue workers here in the Bay Area. The intense shaking you may recall from the main shock of Loma Prieta had collapsed a 1.6 mile section of the Nimitz Freeway through Oakland, referred to as the Cypress Structure, which is really pretty much off in that direction. Now, as the rescuers worked to free people that were trapped in the rubble, the risk of aftershocks damaging the freeway further and injuring the workers became very apparent. So USGS scientists set up a temporary system that radioed alerts to the workers whenever there is a significant aftershock that might shake the Nimitz. Now, we've come a long way since that point in order to be standing here today. And the science behind the USGS Shake Alert system is now powering the nation's first ever earthquake early warning system across the states of California, Oregon, and Washington. More than 60 Shake Alert pilot partners in those states already use Shake Alerts to trigger automated actions for critical infrastructure and to send alert notifications to schools, hospitals, and emergency responders. Now, as we've heard today, and we keep reiterating, earthquake early warning can provide several seconds to tens of seconds warning of an impending shaking. This can save lives, it can reduce injuries, and remember to take actions like drop, cover, and hold on. In addition to warning people, alerts can trigger the automatic actions that the governor and others have mentioned. But still, it's vital to know that for every earthquake, there is going to be a region near the epicenter where alerts will not arrive in time before the shaking begins, because the system needs time to detect the quake, calculate the magnitude, figure out the level of shaking, communicate that, and then that gets pushed out by the apps. Thus, you could receive an alert, as you heard before, during, or after a quake. When you receive an alert, take action immediately, do not wait. Now, moving forward, USGS and its partners are committed to continuing to improve the monitoring that underlies the Shake Alert system performance and to work to improve the speed and reliability because that's what we need to get the best results to protect lives and property. So what's it mean to USGS and the Department of Interior to be here today? It's really exciting. And what it means is that we're advancing toward our goal of helping save lives, reduce injuries, and protect property by having a shake alert system, early warning system, functioning for more than 50 people in the West Coast who are at risk of seismic shaking. Now, nothing of this scale happens, of this scale, complexity, or importance happens without strong partnerships and collaborations. So in closing, I want to thank the states of California, Washington, and Oregon, as well as our many academic and other partners who made this possible and who we're going to continue to work with in the future to improve. And now I'd like to welcome Senator Hill, who, as you know, was instrumental in securing funding for the implementation of the program. Senator Hill.
Thank you very much. What an honor it is to be here today in this celebration. And I want to first thank Governor Newsom for his very strong leadership in bringing us together today and bringing this together to a close in terms of the next step, a step that will work and is working. I want to thank Governor Brown for his vision to bring us to this day, and the Director of Office of Emergency Services, Mark Eroducci, for his commitment and fight to also see that we come and make this happen today. I was born and raised in San Francisco, lived in the Bay Area all my life. I've seen a lot of shaking, seen a lot of destruction, felt a lot of earthquakes. In fact, it was 62 years ago, on March 22nd of 1957, a 5.7 earthquake, and I was in elementary school in San Francisco, when this and other pieces fell from the auditorium, ceiling in the cornice, and dropped down. And no one was hurt, fortunately. It didn't hit anyone. But from that point on, I kept asking the question, wouldn't it be nice? Why can't we know a few seconds or time? What could that do? How important would that be? And as the governor mentioned, all of the things that would prevent and protect people from those BART trains that stop and slow down, the gas lines that may stop, or the elevators that will open the doors and come to a floor and open so everyone can get out, or the fire station doors that will automatically come up so that the trucks and engines can get out. All of those things are critical. Why couldn't that happen? It's happening and starting that process today. I'm grateful and thankful to the scientific expertise that you see behind me. They brought this together today as well. So as a member of the California Seismic Safety Commission, myself and colleagues are trying to do what we can to protect property and get people to be prepared. But it's most important that everyone be prepared and know what to do with those 5 seconds or 10 seconds or 20 seconds. Duck, cover, and hold. That's what's so important. That's what's critical. Thank you for everyone for being here today. And thank you again to the governor for his leadership and strength behind this issue and making sure that we're all safe in California. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator. Thank you. And I just want to remind people, because there was some ambiguity after the Ridgecrest earthquake in Southern California. There's been localized versions of this app. We're around rolling out a statewide version. In Los Angeles, there was a threshold for the alert. There is a threshold today for this alert, and that's 4.5. And I make that point to make the obvious point. You've been reporting a series of quakes in and around this region, some slightly above that threshold, some below. Invariably, someone will ask, well, I didn't get the alert. If it's a 3.7 quake and you felt it, why not? So it's important that we communicate, at least for the time being, and I imagine this is subject to negotiation change, but the 4.5 is the threshold, and not everyone will get that information at the exact same time, depending on where they are. So again, we are grateful for everyone assembling here today, and you've got experts behind me, and we have a mic, and it seems you have the time and the inclination to ask questions. We're here to answer them. I'm going to let, this is why Mark is the director of OES.
So
I think that if I heard your question right, if people are driving and they get this alert, what is their best action, right? It really is to slowly, safely pull your car to the side of the road, stop, and wait for the shaking to pass. You want to make sure that you are stopping in an area that is safe, that you have nothing over the top of you, if at all possible, to be able to, you know, ride out the quake. And that shaking will come through relatively fast. But that's really about the best thing you can do in your vehicle if you're on the highway. And many people feel like, oh, I have a flat tire when they feel an earthquake when they're driving. And so they're not really sure how to approach that. The best thing to do is just to safely and carefully pull to the side of the road and stop your vehicle.
Oh, sorry. Just a follow-up. Where's Richard? Richard, this is an answer because he's prideful.
Sure. Well, we're very proud of the fact that we're launching the system here in California. The question is, so Japan and Mexico has had a system for some time. Why has it taken us longer? And the reason is that the earthquakes are particularly challenging here in California because we live right on top of the faults. The faults are running right through the hills, right here in Oakland, for example, and over on the peninsula. In the case of Japan and Mexico, the earthquakes are mostly offshore, and the original early warning systems were built for these earthquakes that are a little bit further away, so you have more time. So for us to have time to take action here in California, we really needed to speed up the system significantly. We needed to improve our understanding of earthquakes, the engineering of the systems to reduce the delays so that we would still get a warning time. So that's why it's taken us a little time. But now we're very proud. We think we have the most sophisticated early warning system in the world right now.
And Richard, that's in the differentiator of why it's the most sophisticated versus the older systems in Japan and Mexico is what specifically?
So the difference is the fact that not only are we using seismic stations to recognize the beginnings of the earthquake, we're also using these seismic stations to understand the finite extent, how long the fault that's ruptured is. And that really matters in the big earthquakes so that we get really accurate warnings in the really big earthquakes, which are, of course, the ones that really matter.
We are culturally competent in most of our emergency outreach, but as it relates to a Spanish version, Spanish speaking version of the app itself, do we have anything on?
Sure. Sure, yeah, absolutely. The MyShake app right now that's in the store is only in English. That clearly is a limitation. The plan is to have it in other languages as soon as possible. But again, it comes back to the fact that we have something that can be used today, so it's time to put it out there, and we're going to improve it over the coming months, and that is one of the ways that we'll be improving it.
Let me just add, too, that it won't be another language. It's going to be formatted to address people with access and functional needs. And we are actually going to be launching here a very significant public education program that's going to wrap around this entire system and will be pushed down to schools and to businesses, to the community at large. So in the coming weeks, there will be a lot you'll be hearing about earthquake early warning and how the system operates.
Yeah. So Los Angeles is probably the largest system of its type. And there was some question after the Ridgecrake earthquake 7.1 that was felt by some folks in Los Angeles of why that system was not triggered. And that was because of the distance of that quake to that urban core in the LA area. That was a point of concern because folks did not have the benefit of understanding that. There was some communication issues that should have or could have been addressed. It's not a critique, it's just an observation. So it's incumbent upon us to come back to you on a consistent basis and say what this is and what this isn't, and to communicate the thresholds, but also communicate the fact that this is a process that will unfold, meaning we will continue to iterate with this technology. It will not be static, meaning I imagine we'll come back with new versions of this technology that will allow even greater sensitivity, that will allow us to lower that threshold and allow us, obviously, to address the issues of access, et cetera, in different ways. So it's a way of expressing this. This is the state overlay. This is available to everybody in the state of California. I would encourage this to be downloaded by every Californian. To the extent that cities have their own supplemental strategies and versions, that is certainly their right, but we encourage the state being the preeminent overlay and the desired down low. I say this as a former mayor because I want to be respectful, Mayor Schaff, of any efforts at the local level. I don't know. I think that was respectful. I'm trying to be. Yes. All of this, I mean, Alaska is arguably the most seismically impacted state in our nation. As you heard, this is now available in Washington, Oregon. So we want to see this rolled out all across the country. It's your federal tax dollars, not just your state and local dollars that are at play. And USGS obviously wants to see this technology rolled out all across the country. Yeah, you have the WEA technology, which is the Wireless Emergency Alert System, and you now have this new app that will supplement it. It's the integration of the two. Mark can talk more specifically about that.
So the deal with the WEA is that the WEA system allows us to push out the alert to anyone that has a cell phone. It's not an opt-in system. It's used for state or national emergencies. And so we would use the WEA alert system when the magnitude and the ground intensity shaking is of a nature that it will be damaging or could cause injury. And so the difference between the WEA and the app is the app will only, you only get the warnings of the app if you've downloaded the app and you participate in that program. So it's really a making sure we've covered all the bases with regards to the alerting.
And it's also important not to confuse folks, but anyone that comes to San Francisco, lives in San Francisco, every Tuesday at noon, they're reminded of another alert system or communication system, which I remember very, very specifically. We got a federal grant from the Bush administration to harden a World War II system of communication. We were going to tear it down. Instead, we retrofitted it, and it allows a hardening of our communication strategy if these systems go down. Technology is wonderful when it's accessible. So we have hardened the system. It's a way of expressing this. There are many supplemental strategies for communication. We're not arguing this is the only one. This is just complementary to many of those other systems.
So when you get an alert on MyShake, it pops up and it audibly says earthquake, drop cover, hold on, shaking expected. And then if you look at your phone, there'll be a card that says exactly that. So it doesn't tell you about the strength of shaking. It also doesn't tell you about how long until the shaking. And the decision to do this is based on a lot of work done by the Shake Alert project as a whole with the USGS to understand what is it that is the right message to send to users. And the right message is to simply tell people there's an earthquake, drop cover, hold on. You start providing additional information, it causes confusion, and so that's why it's a very, very simple message.
Guys, would they one or two more high-level ones with the governor, and they will have a scientist available after?
I'm sorry, ma'am.
So the first order thing that everybody needs to know in an earthquake is you drop cover and hold on wherever you are. It doesn't matter where you are in a building. There is not going to be the kind of warning to start evacuating buildings, for example, so drop cover and hold on. As for the building infrastructure, we are very fortunate in California that we have very good building codes now. The challenge, of course, is that not all buildings, not older buildings, are up to those building codes. So when it comes to building safety, it's really about when it was built.
And we're... Well, the Title 24, the new building codes, and then subsequent local building codes that have been adopted that are different in each city. I can assure you San Francisco, one of those cities that led on soft stories and requirements related to those corner buildings with garages on the ground floor that are most vulnerable. So that's a different answer depending on where you are in the state. But the modern building codes have been in effect since the 70s, probably at the scale that's the closest approximation to an answer to that question. Anybody up? By the way, I can't impress upon you more. It's sort of a PSA moment. 72hours.org. It's the 30th anniversary of Loma Prieta. If nothing else, if you refuse to download the app, at least get the information on 72hours.org. And if you do it for yourself, if you don't do it for yourself, do it for your spouse, for your kids, do it for your pets, because you may have forgotten about an emergency plan for your pets. Do it for your neighbors, 72hours.org, culturally competent site, one of the most comprehensive that exists out there. Anybody else? It's individualized based upon where you're standing in the world, but we could talk more about that, Richard. But that's why you have to do the location component on your settings.
Sure. So as the governor says, it's really important not only that you download the app, but you allow location services, because that's the way that the app knows where you are, and that means we can give you an alert for the region. If you're in the region that's going to experience the shaking, then you will get an alert. For the magnitude 4.5 earthquake a couple of days ago, that was actually a great test for the app just a few days before this launch. The app did the shake alert system, the underlying system that detects the earthquakes generates the alert, shake alert. It generated an alert. The MyShake system ingested it. It determined what region where there was going to be shaking intensity 3, and it pushed out an alert, a silent alert, to the phones in that region. So we were very pleased with that process. It sort of showed that we really were ready to roll out.
And just final point, because she invited us, we'll end as we began by thanking Mayor Schaaf. Why are we here with Libby Schaaf? It's because she, as mayor, was the first to allow us to pilot this program at scale in March of this year. And I just want to applaud her leadership in this space and her willingness to allow this to be implemented at scale. She inspired San Diego to follow up after that. Thank you. Thank you all very much.